Hey guys, David back at you with Express Auto again. Today we've got a 2015 GMC Denali pickup on the rack. Vehicle came in with a no move condition. Long story short, the guy said it started making this weird shaking and then it just stopped moving entirely. So it's got a 6L80 in it. We're gonna rip it out and take it apart and see what we can find wrong. I just want to give you guys a general idea of what we do whenever we are pulling the transmission out. Some guys know what goes on, some guys don't. So just give you a kind of heads up of how we do it and what we do, and we're gonna get started. We've already got this truck on the rack. Wanted to make sure it was safe before we get too adventurous. We're gonna unhook the battery and pull our dipstick out. I don't know how well you guys can see, but the dipstick is not supposed to be that color. A really good way to show you what it's not supposed to be is put it on a piece of something here, and you can see the chunkies falling off the end of the dipstick. Something is definitely not right. So, I want to take it up and get our tool cart over and see if we can't get this thing in the air. We're gonna start taking stuff apart. If you guys have any questions about what happens and why we're doing it that way, feel free to reach out and ask. Everybody starts in a different spot. I always start at the rear exhaust bolt because I'm a weirdo. Back to the rear drive shaft.
Tranny mount.
Sorry, I forgot to tell you what I was doing there. I removed the front drive shaft.
Four bolts there.
Yep, all 7/16. Out the tranny mount bolts there are 15mm. Now we are going to move to a bigger impact. We're going to zip out the front mounted bolts. They're 21 over 21. Pop our vent hose line out. No reason to break the clip. Auto loose. We're going to put us a tripod in here.
really work with them. That one's gonna be a stuck one, so may have to reach inside of it and unclip it if I can. There she goes.
That one was just nice and stuck.
All there is to it. Make sure we get her unlooped from the top and down.
So it doesn't hang up when you're pulling the exhaust down.
Yep, don't want to rip the exhaust or the O2 sensor wiring out, just trying to lower it down.
You boys can't tell it, but it's getting a little warm in here. I'm gonna crack a window real quick.
Not your average window.
The industrial window.
Huh. All right. Now we can take out some exhaust manifold bolts.
Well, exhaust collector bolts.
Three bolt flange.
These guys have been known to be a little stuck, so we're gonna cross our fingers and hope that we don't break any of them today.
Mother trucker, that was
a little bit tight.
Yeah, it's got four collector bolts up there on the where the downpipe would be, I guess, on a turbo.
Right.
And there's two not quite a half inch apart, and then there's two that's like 2 inches apart up against the block on the inside.
Man. That'd be a total pain in the turkey.
Buy her a better sandwich maker.
This is my thumb that I cut on the fan shroud.
Kept busting open.
Yep.
Blood everywhere.
All right, this is our last bolt.
We should probably be wearing safety glasses.
You know, that is not a bad thing to say. We definitely should be wearing safety glasses for this fun operation.
But do as we say, not as we do.
Exactly. That's exactly right.
Oh, get that exhaust unstuck.
Stuck right there on that collector flange.
Make it pop loose that time.
See if we can get it to come off of there. May have to take that bolt just a little bit looser.
And these are notorious for splitting and breaking and causing exhaust leaks, because this is like a mesh for protection on the outside, and there's small little flex pipe on the inside.
Yep. Yeah, they are super bad about cracking. That's part of why we take our time and use an end wrench back here and not an air ratchet. Sit there and smack that thing a few times with an air ratchet, and it'll usually break that flex pipe. So, not all the time if you're good and you pay attention to what you're doing, but.
I mean, they are fairly durable, but still, that after time, you know, something that's sitting there supposed to move that doesn't move a whole lot, and then doing this, you put a lot more stress on them.
Yep. All right. Let's see if we got her.
There we go.
We're off of the ball now.
And if something like that happens where it's broken, we would replace that.
Yep. Absolutely.
You just cut the pipe and weld a new one on.
Yep. Now the fun part. Getting the exhaust out of the hole. Hey, right there. I'm an exhaust.
Can you make exhaust sounds?
Yeah, sounds great. It's running perfect.
Has it got a cam?
A small one. Real small.
All right. Oh, we got that big bulky turkey out of the way. We're going to take some other stuff off.
Go ahead and get our heat shield
off there and out of the way.
It'd be nice to have that quarter inch ratchet.
You know, I still don't think I would use it. It's that's a nice tool.
That's okay, because I've been using the crap out of it.
Have you? All right.
Those tens?
Yep, 10 millimeter. We got two bolts on the heat shield. Guys, GM put that on there for a reason. It needs to go back on the vehicle. See a lot of different vehicles come in where that dude is just flat missing.
That's like the LS swap that David just did on my Toyota. Yeah. There are so many spots where it's so tight where it needs stuff like this here on all the wires, and we just don't know.
Yep.
Because it's like I said, LS swapped, and you just don't know.
Yeah, you don't know where it needs a heat shield versus where it would have originally had a heat shield. All right.
We've about got it all figured out to where all that stuff needs to be, because the heat will tell you when it starts to melt your wires.
Yep. That weird plastic burning smell is not good. Yeah, it might be good if you want to collect an insurance check, but not good for your vehicle if you want it to stay on the road. Trying to work left-handed, that didn't work at all. My left-hand was like, what are you doing? This is not where I belong.
When you've got more money in your motor swap than your truck's worth.
You definitely have a problem.
You definitely don't want it to burn down.
True.
Because your insurance company is not going to warranty or insure that.
Nope.
I guess it might if you go to Lloyd's of London or something, but then you're going to have super high.
Yeah. All right. Now we're going to start on getting the starter out of the way so we can get to the door converter bolts.
Well, that's nice to get that starter out.
Yeah, this is not one of the funner ones to do. It's not terrible, but it's definitely not fun. Heat shields and their starter connectors, so they're a little bit different than the earlier design. Earlier one just had a big snap-on hoop that went over the top of the starter. This one's a little bit more involved.
Two more tens, I think.
A 10 and a 13. And here's another area, guys, where make sure your battery is unhooked, otherwise you're gonna smell that burning plastic smell.
or welding.
Yeah, or welding smell. It's not good either way, no matter how you slice it. This shield likes to get hung up back here on the back. Just take your time, it'll come out of there. Don't rip it. Another little deflector off of there to where we can actually see the starter terminals. There we are. Oh, safety clip came out. These ones, I always have a hard time getting that release to actually release. And same thing, the safety clip broke off inside. That's okay.
Yeah.
Yep. Bad area. But that's okay. We'll get in there and we'll snap her out of there real quick. Thank you. Thank you.
only come a town about twice a year.
David, move his hand. I could show you guys.
Oh, sorry. I got it right there.
Right. There.
Yep.
Right there.
Right inside of there. That safety clip likes to break, and then starter doesn't want to unplug. But that's okay. We'll reach in there and we'll move the safety out of the way. Like so. We'll release the pin. Try to release the pin. And this right here is why R&R can take some time. Sometimes this kind of stuff just happens and you just roll with it. I can't get that terminal to pull off there.
Come and get you side cutters. We'll get it off.
You know, as effective as that might be, I don't think that's the solution here. Get it off there. As stuck as it is, I may have to have a new terminal. Because I got it released and she just does not want to. There she goes.
Well, that danged old sand and grime.
Yeah. Try not to tear it up. Don't want to have to replace it if we don't need to. Oh, there we go. Now we have a starter out of the way. Millimeter socket. Always trying to run away. Taking off the starter shield here.
110?
Yep, 110.
It's plastic, isn't it?
Yeah. Another thing I see, you guys leave this thing off all the time. GM put it on there, put it back.
Just 110.
I mean, it's one bolt. One little bolt. It's not that hard. Alrighty. Now for the fun part. This, to me, is one of the most interesting parts of this adventure.
Torque converter bolts.
Torque converter bolts. And see, with that starter out of the way,
we can just get right in there and zip them out. Just like so.
Nice torque converter bolt.
How many does this one have?
This one will have three.
Now for next bolt hole and take out the next one. That's another one out.
Said just three, right?
Yep, just three of them. Only seven more to go. Plus or minus seven, same thing.
Now you're scratching the bell housing.
I know. Luckily, they're not big scratches. This is another area you should wear safety glasses whenever you are doing this. Otherwise, you could get some of those little metal shavings there in your eyes. Or you can avoid the metal shavings. Whichever one you want to do.
Last one right there.
Yep, that's it.
Then we'll move to those.
Bell housing bolts.
Nope.
Nope.
No.
You can't take out the bell housing bolts before you
you take the transfer case out, it'll fall out.
We can't have our transmission falling out on us. Now that we've got our converter bolts out, I like to stick my pry bar up there and just push the converter back to make sure that it is all the way out of the back of the crank, or at least free. We don't want to get in there and it's stuck so bad you can't get the transmission lower down. We're gonna move on to our transfer case after this. I like to take the transfer case out, then the transmission out. Some guys take them out as one whole assembly and strap them down and do all that. It's easier to me just to take them out individually, one at a time. These transfer cases are a little hefty. They're not extremely heavy. If you're gonna do this by yourself, it can be done, but use proper lifting equipment so you don't kill yourself or end up with a transfer case on your toe, that kind of thing. No, nobody wants to lose a toe to a transfer case, especially not a Chevrolet one. I mean, if I'm gonna lose my toe to anything, it better be something better than a Chevrolet transfer case. Pop our vent hose off and
the vent hose. The vent hose is puking.
Ruh-roh, Ryan. That's okay. A little bit of oil hitting the floor never hurt nobody. I like to pull off my shifter linkage and get everything out of the way of getting to my transfer case bolts. These are a T40 Torx bit. Usually break them free and they just roll on out of there. Another area where some guys have debate. Some guys say take the lever off here. Some guys say take the complete lever off. Get our speed sensor unhooked here. That is all of our transfer case wire. Try to use our body panel pliers to reach up top and pull that tie out of there. We like to try to put everything back where it came out of the factory. So try not to break all the plastic clips and all the little tie down. There we go. We are ready to take a transfer case out.
Do you take it off at the transmission or at the transfer case?
I take them off at the transfer case. I like to take it off at the extension housing. This extension housing is not known to be an issue on the 6L80s, but on some units, if you take them out on the wrong side, you can't get the transfer case out. So keep that in mind if you guys are doing one of these at home. and you decide to take it out on the wrong side, that shaft is going to stick out of the back of that transmission yay far. And if you slide this back and you've got a cross member right here, you can't get the transfer case out.
Look at that guy right there. And that one is part of the frame.
Yep, there's no unbolting that cross member. Back her up just a little bit.
Like that's your billet wood block?
Yeah, custom wood block. It only comes in like a 2.5 by 2.5 by 6. I don't know why. I would like to get it in a 12-foot section or a 12-inch section, but they don't make it. I don't know why. Trying to get me a Bluetooth block. Can't find one. Out of stock everywhere. Shipping's delayed.
COVID's got it.
COVID's got it. Yeah, we like to cheat using air jack. I'd like to have air over air, but we currently only have air over hydraulics. So. Hydraulic over air, however that's said. I'm not a jack specialist. I'm not specialized in jacking off or knowing anything about a jack. I just know how to push the handle. As you guys can see, this thing does not fit on the jack worth a squat. But that's okay. We're not going for a super fit here. What I like to do is a little unorthodox, but we'll unbolt the transfer case and actually just rest it on the jack and hold on to everything. If you're gonna do it this way and you haven't done this before, put a strap on it so you don't drop it. You drop the transfer case and somebody's gonna be really unhappy.
Only if you break it. Or your foot.
However high up in the air that thing is, I'm gonna bet money that aluminum will not bounce. Could be wrong.
It'll
go before.
Thud.
Go ahead and pop our rear drive shaft out now. Yeah. We're not gonna pop our rear drive shaft out. Got another stuck one. Big green pry bar. This is probably one of my favorite tools in the entire shop. And it really doesn't have that many uses, but I love this tool. When it comes to a rusted in U joint, it works.
The heck you say it won't come out?
I said get out.
It's having a Whitney and Bobby moment. We'll get her out of there. I always like to flex my yoke, check our U-joints. If you notice that you've got a bad U-joint now, it's a lot easier to get it done before the transmission's been overhauled. All right, now we will start taking out some transfer case bolts and see if we can't get this guy out of here.
Was there four of those?
Should be six of those.
Six of them.
Yep. These are all 15 millimeter. You guys don't have one of these guys, I feel sorry for you. This definitely makes the job so much easier.
Double floppy.
It's a these are Cornwell brand. Mac used to make them. I don't know if Mac still makes them or not. I don't have a Mac tool guy anymore, unfortunately. But the Cornwell ones, they come in a 12 point metric or standard double. And they can reach around corners and work on goofy bolts a lot easier. Thankfully, there's an engineer for wrenches like there's an engineer for cars. lower it down nice and slow. I was almost in sync with that.
Yeah.
Well, we will set this guy off to the side. I like to put the tail housing up a little bit so it doesn't leave you a lake in your shop. It's entirely the guy's choice of how big of a mess he wants to clean up. Got our jack back up. At this point, I like to take out my lower two bell housing bolts so they're out of the way while the tripod's still there. With the jack in there, it gets a little hairy. Cooler line bolt, but we're not going to remove the cooler line. We're just going to remove the bolt for now. Break that line loose, it's going to lose a fair amount of fluid. Not a ton, but it's going to lose a fair amount.
What's so, fair?
Quart and a half, something like that. I don't know. Fair and a half.
I like it.
Fair's more than a little and not quite as much as a bunch, but definitely more than a skosh. So we're gonna angle her down a little bit here.
Good part only goes so far.
Yep. Good part about the way they designed that is it only goes that far. You can move your training jack or your tripod out of the way. Yeah, we'll go in with our training jack. Speed racer.
Bless me.
You're blessed. All righty. Now we're ready for the fun stuff. All right. We are going to start with taking out some bell housing bolts that have nuts over the top of them. There's some heat shields and brackets and harness brackets and
passenger side
up there. Well,
or top.
One up on top. There's one on this driver's side that's a real turkey to get to. So I like to reach up there and pop that little clip off where the harness can be out of your way. There's a little plastic clip right here. If we can get it to pop off without breaking. There she goes. Get that guy popped off. Take our fuel line clip bracket back here off. I'm gonna move that harness out of our way to get to the nut. One little tin right there. Now we just kind of massage this guy up out of the way a little bit. We get to that 13 millimeter nut. Right there.
Right there.
That's all right. I'll get out. Get my wonderful extendo mount on. Now I'll pop that line off there. like so. I like to go ahead and knock all the bell housing bolts out on this side while we're here. And then we'll move to the other side.
Over here.
Wrong side. Now then, we will take out our dipstick nut, because well, everybody's got to have a dipstick nut. Now we're going to do one of the more funner parts to do here. All the way up at the very tippy-tippy top is that little plastic guy. I'm sure there are special tools out there made just for doing that, but I'll show you guys our custom in-house tool here. A piece of 3/8 steel brake line with a little hook made on the end. If you guys don't have one, call me. I'll make you one. They're super cheap. Discounted price, $99.95, one-time offer.
But wait, that's not it.
That's not it. For an extra $99.95, I will send you one unbent. Do it yourself.
Alright, see if we can't get up on that nut right there. And,
here again, this custom made in-house tool. I'm going to reach up there and slide that bracket right out of the way.
I think you're a little high. I think we need to do $9.99, not $99.99.
Okay. We'll do $9.99. That does not include free shipping, though. Push our dipstick tube up out of the socket there to where we get to the last bolt on that side. Alright, time to take out some last three bell housing bolts. Thought that one was a goner.
There's just not a good spot to see.
I got it.
Now the question is, will the transmission come out? So, a lot of these that we've been seeing
a bunch of the 6L80 family, to say the least. And a lot of these guys are getting stuck on the dowels because the dowel pins are steel and your case is aluminum and they just flat freaking seize. So, we're gonna stick a pry bar up there incorrectly and see if it'll wiggle. If it won't, I'll try to drive the dowel pins a little bit. Yep. She is not moving at all.
Let me
they get nice and seized like this. I like to take a handle of the punch, give them a couple of taps. When the tapping doesn't work, you grab the big green pry bar and you give her a little bit of the hee-hoers. Come on. Man, we got us nice stuck on today.
I don't know how to do that, but it never hurts to take 2 seconds and walk back around. Double check, double check. Nobody wants to go down to break one, but forgot to take the ball out and go back.
Ever have been friends.
No.
There she goes. All right.
And as I said earlier, now
we'll pop the cooler lines off. Not a very, very good amount coming out today.
Boy, that's some clean fluid. That's supposed to be red, guys. Girls.
Anybody's.
Yeah, but that's black.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, can I say that?
It is definitely dark.
Is it? I don't even know anymore. Neutral.
our gender neutral shift juice.
Yeah, is not its normal color.
Has lost its blood.
I guess we've been successful. The transmission is out. We're definitely gonna have to do some filing on the back of the mating service on the back of that block. But for the most part, guys, that's how one of these things comes out. Sometimes they can be a little bit cantankerous, so to speak. But once you get it off the dowels, it's not too bad. So if you guys have any questions, feel free to like, comment, all that wonderful stuff. Let us know what you guys think. If you guys have any thoughts of wanting to see a different transmissioner or wanting to see a different vehicle or, hell, want to see us work on something different than a transmission, just let us know. Like, share, subscribe, and we'll be back here in a little bit with the teardown on this guy.